Good day and welcome to Space Station Live and the International Space Station Flight Control Room in Houston, Texas. Today the crew is preparing for tomorrow's grapple unberthing and release of the Japanese HTV-4 cargo ship. It's been about a month since that cargo ship arrived at the space station. All of the cargo has been transferred from HTV-4 to the space station. Tomorrow we'll be getting coverage of that activity with an extended Space Station Live. We will expect to have the robotic arm activities as they reach out. It's already been moved to a power and data grapple fixture on the Harmony module, and the crew will grapple the HTV-4, move it away, and extend it out to the full length of the 68-foot-long Canadian robotic arm known as Canadarm 2, orient it properly for its departure, and then perform the release of HTV-4. HTV-4 will be re-entering and destroying a lot of trash that has been collected aboard the International Space Station, freeing up much-needed space aboard the space station as it ends its journey to resupply the International Space Station with a fiery burn-up over the Pacific Ocean. The crew just now closed the hatch. We have some views of Karen Nyberg, Luca Parmentano, and Chris Cassidy as they were finishing up the closure of that hatch. Again, release is scheduled for about 10:55 a.m., just before 4:11 a.m. Central Time. Meanwhile, Pavel Vinogradov, Chris Cassidy, and Alexander Mazurkin are loading items in their Soyuz spacecraft in preparation for their undocking and landing in Kazakhstan about 1 week from today. And this follows a celebration of Saturday of Station Commander Pavel Vinogradov's 60th birthday. Research is going to be very important this week again. The crew members will be working with the reaction self-test, some fluid experiments, some combustion experiments, the SPHERES vehicles that are testing automated rendezvous activities inside, and gathering some spinal ultrasound. They'll also be doing some periodic fitness evaluations, hearing tests, and things of the like. Maintenance-wise, they'll be doing some recycling tank drains into the other cargo vehicle that's docked to the station, the automated transfer vehicle, the European Space Agency vehicle, and doing some weekly water balancing among the different tanks and replacing an air selector valve. This past weekend on Saturday, ATV-4 thrusters that are on the far end of the Russian segment of the station were fired for 3.5 minutes to reboost the station's to an altitude of less than half a mile more than it was. But now it's at 262 by 252 statute mile orbit. That reboost puts the station at the right altitude and phasing for the upcoming landing of Expedition 36. Next Tuesday, and then for the launch of Expedition 37-38 crew on September 25. That crew will be heading for a same-day arrival and docking at the International Space Station featuring NASA Flight Engineer Mike Hopkins, Flight Engineer and Soyuz Commander Oleg Kotov, and Flight Engineer Sergei Ryaznyeky. Today they were being tested on their knowledge of Russian segment systems on the space station. Chris Cassidy, with the help of Karen Nyberg, spent about 7 hours on Saturday continuing to troubleshoot the problem with Luca Parmitano's spacesuit that has been the focus of a lot of attention since water leaked into his helmet during a July 16 spacewalk that ended up being cut short because of that. The Saturday troubleshooting did eat into their Labor Day holiday a little bit, but they did get Monday off like most folks on the ground in the United States. This is Mission Control Houston.